Welcome to the tutorial Quickstart of Software XSOFT-CODESYS V3 on a modular PLC XC300. This example will show how to start the software XSOFT-CODESYS V3, create a project using a standard template, and write a simple program for an XC300 modular PLC. The following technical requirements must be met for this: a license for the software XSOFT-CODESYS V3, available as single or multi-user license, a modular PLC XC300, here the XC303 C32002 is used, a patch cable, for example DXCBL RG45-3M0, optional a USB to RG45 adapter if no switch or no free RG45 interface is available for the connection via Ethernet. The software is started with a double click. The necessary project modules are loaded. A new project can be started via the shortcut or via File, New Project. For the first start, it is recommended not to start with an empty project, but with a standard project. At this point, the project name and the location of the project can be defined directly. The desired PLC XC303 and the desired programming language ST are selected. The project is then displayed in the device tree with the selected PLC and the first program block that is called in the task. In the library manager, the standard libraries are listed, so that it is possible to start with the basic blocks. Basically, the software is divided into different windows. On the left is the device tree, where all the applications are visible. With the selection of the PLC, then the editing window is to be seen on the right side, with which the program can be edited. At the bottom, you can see the message window. This can be displayed or minimized as desired. The Fix button can be used to continuously display the message window at the desired screen size. Here, the autocompiler would then directly display errors during programming. All windows can be arranged dynamically as desired. If the windows are to be reset to the factory settings, this can be realized via Window and then Reset Window Layout. For the first program, the declaration is ideally started. For this, there are two different modes. Once the freely editable mode Textual View or the Tabular mode Tabular View. In this example, the freely editable mode Textual View is selected. The first input is an integer variable for a counter between var and endvar. By entering two slashes, a comment is added to the variable. This procedure is generally recommended to ensure clarity in the program. With the now following line in the programming part, the counter is incremented in every cycle. With this, the first simple project is written. The verification of the written line is done either via the more recommendable shortcut for Build F11 or via the menu item Build and then Build F11. The successful result is displayed in the message window. For example, the semicolon is removed and the compilation is triggered again. An error is now displayed in the message window with the note that a semicolon is expected at the end of the POU. If an error-free program is available, a communication to the PLC must be created in the next step. For this purpose, the communication window of the X303 is open on the left in the device tree by double-clicking. The factory set IP addresses of the three Ethernet interfaces of the XC303 C32002 used here is shown in the displayed image. The information on how to change the IP address can be found in the manual MN050005 of the XC303 in chapter Changing the IP Address on the Controller. In this example, the default IP address 192.168.137.248 of the Ethernet interface ETH1 is used. On the one hand, a fixed IP address of the PLC can be entered, or on the other hand, the faster variant via scan network is selected. In the appearing window, suitable devices are displayed. In this case, only one PLC appears, which is then selected. The LED on the PLC, which was previously gray, now changes to green light, like the LED on the gateway. Some explanations about the available program functions. In the menu item Online, you can, among other things, log in, log out, and create boot application. In the menu item Build are all necessary tools to create a project. The Debug menu item provides runtime support for debugging the running project. With the shortcut Login Alt F8 or via the menu Online and then Login Alt F8, an online connection to the PLC can now be established. The online view appears. At the bottom, it is shown that the PLC is in stop. Via the shortcut Start F5, it is now tried to start the PLC. But this doesn't happen because the hardware switch of the PLC is still set to Stop On. When the hardware switch of the PLC is moved to Stop Off, the PLC starts. In the device tree on the left side, the online mode can now be opened via PLC_PRG. It becomes visible how the program counter increments and thus the program sequence works correctly. Now a Create Boot application can be triggered via menu item Online. The boot application causes the PLC to start with the compiled program after switching off and on again. For the connection of further hardware to the PLC, the lockout Ctrl+F8 is done. To do this, right-click on device XC303 in the device tree and select Add Device from the context menu. In the new window that appears, various field buses can now be accessed or the driver of the XN300 master can be selected via miscellaneous for the local extension slice modules available in this hardware configuration. If the intended hardware is not yet available during the project setup, the individual desired extension slices can be added offline via the context menu. In this tutorial, the more comfortable way with Scan for Devices is used for existing hardware. Searching for connected devices in this situation results in an error message, because the stack XN300 master is not yet present in the PLC. To achieve this, a login into the PLC takes place. Now it is possible to scan for connected slices in the online mode as well in the offline mode shown here. and the found slices can be added to the project. With log out and log in again, the existing slices are then displayed in green in the device tree. In this situation, it is not yet possible to test the slices via a simulation. The input and output values are displayed in gray. This can be recognized by the fact that in always update variables, the configuration is set to use parent device setting. To change the setting, logout from the PLC is required. The XC303 is selected in the device tree. In the device window that appears, the PLC settings are selected. When configuring always update variables, the default setting must be changed from disabled update only if used in a task to enable one use bus cycle task if not used in any task. The setting is recommended especially for the beginning to be able to test the existing hardware. If the variables are afterwards used, an update takes place in the corresponding task. With login again and the start of the PLC, the hardware can be tested now. In the I/O image, the whole tree is expanded to make the status change of the connected inputs, here X1.1 and X1.2, visible in the online mode. With the completion of the project, a Create Boot application is now triggered via online. For data storage, the created project is saved. Thank you for your attention.